The WB Friday continues as students afraid to speak out against prejudice are ready to be heard. And now, an all-new Popular.
Sure. Hey, have you been dining lately?
Try.
Oh, well, keep it up, bro. You are looking good.
Yo, thanks, Josh.
Yeah. And that cologne you're wearing is off the chain. Wait a minute. What I meant to say was that that shirt just really brings out your eyes, I guess.
Stop it, you silly beast, you.
Well, what's up, baby?
You're awfully happy today.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Excuse me. Hi, is chemistry this way?
It's that way.
Hi, I'm Lily.
Brian. Brian Rose.
Nice to meet you. It's at the end of the hall.
Thanks.
See you there. Guys, that was not cool.
What? We won't make a fun of him.
Yeah, I know, but you made him feel uncomfortable.
Oh, calm down, Lily. Let's just go shopping.
Shopping?
Yeah. Glad to see the new Zoo Review has decided to join us. Today's topic, exploring the meaning behind the phrase, got milk? More specifically, the homogenization process. I squeezed this from the udders of a Guernsey cow at Butch's petting zoo on the way in this morning. You see this layer of cream at the top? Well, so did my personal role model, Mr. Augusta Gallin. Ms. Julian.
So what you're saying is that raw milk is like our culture. The cream always rises to the top.
Exactly. You see, my horrid little snot-nosed monsters, the homogenization process also mirrors our culture. The more things are alike, the better they work together and the longer they last.
That doesn't take into account individual differences, sir.
Excuse me, President of the Lullaby League. Shut your divisive mouth and celebrate homogenization, hmm?
But you go for some homogenization, couldn't you, Joshy?
Miss Glass, can you ask these guys to stop it? It's not cool.
Okay, so we gotta drop the faggot.
Well, get off your soapbox, Jane Fonda. Nobody's getting hurt here.
How do you know that?
Miss Esposito, mind your own business. If you have something to say to me, say it after class when my valuable teaching time is over. Moving on! Who wants to taste my milk?
You're guilty of cultivating an environment of hate. If a student can't feel safe in the classroom, where can they feel safe?
Miss Esposito, amuse me. Tell me exactly what I did wrong today.
You were a statistic. 97% of students in high school hear the word fag or other homophobic words used every day by their peers, many times in front of a teacher, and the teacher does nothing.
This is chemistry, not Amnesty International. Besides, you're being ridiculous. It's just a word.
Just a word? I bet if someone said the N-word in your class, you would march their butt straight to the principal's office.
Damn right I would.
Then why is the word fag treated any differently?
Look, no kids in my class are gay.
That you know of. If they are, that word makes them hide. It hurts.
Go crochet a heart so you can wear it on your sleeve. You've made your point.
No, I haven't. But I will.
Over once or twice, what lasts the longest in this life? Character or rock hard size? In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well, maybe.
Hey, Brian.
Hi.
I just wanted to apologize for what happened in there.
Why are you apologizing to me?
I just didn't want you to think that everyone in the school is homophobic.
And I would care because?
I don't mean to be presumptuous or anything, but I just wanted to let you know that I'm starting a gay and lesbian student support club.
I'm not gay.
Cool. But if you are, you decide you are. I just wanted you to know that there's a place where...
Are you?
Well, I admit that Last year, I did some experimenting, mostly in my head. But today, I'm totally happy with my boyfriend. But anyway, because of what happened last year, I know what it's like to be made fun of and stuff. So if you're even remotely bi-curious, I just...
I'm not. And I don't want you hanging around me anymore. Okay?
Brooke McQueen, please report to the principal's office. Brooke McQueen, please report to the principal's office.
Principal Krebs, is something
wrong? Yes. You've been a very bad, bad girl by not leaving me your telephone number the night of the party.
Jimmy, what are you doing here? Where is Principal Krebs?
He's doing his regular 10:30 workout, which gives us about 4 minutes and 58 seconds of quality time.
I'm guessing that you're pulling an A in this detective class.
Actually, no, I think I'm getting a D. I've been spending most of my time hot on your trail. Sit. Do you know how many high schools I've been scoping out looking for you? I think the police may have a tail on me. I have something for you. You left it the night of the party.
I feel like Drew and Ever After.
And I am here to take you to the ball. So, let's celebrate by making a day of it.
Now? I can't go now. I'm in school.
But Risk isn't just a board game, bro. Come on, let's live it.
I can't. I'll get...
In trouble? Okay. Can I at least have your telephone number so that we can make formal arrangements?
That I can do.
Okay. You smell good.
You smell like trouble.
Leave your 2000. What? Can't handle hanging out with an older guy?
I'll risk it.
Call you.
So, what did Principal Krupp say about the whole gay and lesbian group thing?
Well, he had some reservations, but he said as long as I find a faculty member to endorse it, I can go ahead, which I realize is easier said than done.
Wait a minute. Why are you forming a gay club? Are you...
No, sweetie, it's just a support club. Anybody can join. It's gonna be great.
You know, though, this is sort of serious stuff. There's a lot of controversy around these gay groups. Think about all those kids in El Medino in Orange County. They joined this gay group, and then they got beat up and spit on.
Yeah, Carmen's right, Lily. Maybe you should think of another way to help out.
Are you guys looking for an excuse to not join? Great, because I've been thinking, and Carm, I nominate you for vice president. Devil, Harrison, you can be secretary.
I'm in. You're not gay, are you, Harrison? No, it's okay if you are. I just want people to know that I'm not.
I'm not gay, but my mom is. Besides, we know you're not gay. You don't dress well enough.
Look, I'm no hater. It's just, I don't know.
I just want to feel like you fit in. Dude, I totally understand. Sometimes I hear the guys in the locker room say gay slurs, and I've done nothing. I'm not proud of it, but it's true.
How could you hear that crap and do nothing?
Come on, Lily. We're guys. We're not Gandhi. It's complicated. I want to do right. Do I always succeed? No. But right now, by joining a club, I'm trying, okay?
Thanks. I knew I could count on my friends.
Well, I didn't really say that I was in.
Carmen, you've been discriminated against.
Okay, did you not just hear what Harrison said? It's complicated. Thanks to Nicole, last year everyone at the school found out about our little experiment. I don't want to be made fun of again, and if I join that gay group, they'll probably tease me, and I'm over that. You have Josh, and I have nobody. And besides, I got a job at the mall, and I'm starting this week. Look, I'm sorry. It's hard for me, but I'm not budging on this one.
Hey, Lily. I'll join your club. I can see how much it means to you. You can consider it an apology for how I acted earlier.
Thanks, baby. How about you, Sam?
Actually, George and I are going shopping for a prom dress tomorrow after school.
Oh, great. Glad your priorities are in order.
Lily, come on. You know I am down with your causes. When you were against vivisection, I was there. I slept in a treehouse for you. I gave up veal for you. I wore pleather for you.
Fine.
Come on. I blew off 2 dates with George last week so I could help you with your annual Karen Silkwood bumper car fundraiser. I'm down with your politics. I can't be a part of this effort. I need a teen life.
Sorry.
Yeah, so are the people who need your support.
What's up, fag? Fag.
Excuse me, I have an announcement to make. Today after school will be the first meeting of the Kennedy Student Support Gay and Lesbian Club, which you are all invited to attend. We have our first three members, myself, Josh, and Harrison. We decided to create a safe space for students to feel accepted.
Fat chance, Miss Esposito. I'll have that little club of yours shut down faster than you can say, Paul, when? This club is not appropriate for Kennedy High.
And Miss Glass is a perfect example of why we students need to support one another. Next thing you know, she'll be quoting damnation Bible verses.
Like Leviticus, which says homosexuality is a no-no. Think again, Miss Esposito. I won't do that, because I'm forbidden by law to mix church and state. Stop pushing in everybody's face, but some people will never, can never accept.
Principal Krebs has already given me the go-ahead as long as we find a faculty advisor.
You won't find an advisor for that, miss, because here at Kennedy, we do not, cannot push the gay agenda.
All we're supporting is the right to love, the right to find a job without being discriminated against, the right to not live in fear of violence. That is not a gay agenda, Miss Glass. That's a human agenda. That's what this club is about. And by the way, you may want to consider volunteering for the faculty advisor position.
Bite me.
Wow. I have to say, I'm a little confused by your behavior, sir. After all, last year, you were instrumental in creating the booty camp sensitivity session that we all attended. But that's okay. I mean, we could all use a refresher course.
60% of this country is against homosexuality. Cross a majority and like it or not, you get hurt. AKA Matthew Shepard. Be aware of that. No amount of preaching stops that.
Then what's the alternative? Silence? Letting people live in pain? I'll take that risk, sir.
Baby.
Oh, you know, it was like...
Good arm, Ford.
Oh, hey, thanks, Dave. Just doing what comes natural.
Yeah, speaking of that, me and the guys here were thinking, well, maybe you'd like to join varsity this year.
Are you serious? Bro, that'd be great.
Yeah, there's just one problem. You know, we can't shower in the locker room with you, you know.
Oh, no, hey, don't worry about that. My athlete's foot, it's totally cleared up.
We can't shower with you because you're a fag.
No, I think you got the wrong guy, Farber.
Really? No, I don't think so. Your girlfriend started that club, which means she's gay, which means you're gay, too.
No, you're wrong, bro. My girlfriend's club is...
Anyway, we can't play with fags. We just thought you should know.
Don't call me a fag.
Is that a challenge, gay boy?
You know, you're way out of line right now, Dave.
Yeah, back off,
Farber. Shut up, Grace. Why don't you take your little wheel here and the two of you go out dancing?
You know, you say one more thing to
and
us...
And you're gonna what? Huh? Fag.
I do realize this is only going to get worse.
What I realize is this is a blessing in disguise. It proves that there's hatred and homophobia at the school, and it proves we need a club like the one we're starting. Josh, what happened to your eye?
Well, that's great. That's really great, you guys. Hey.
Would you calm down and tell me what's wrong?
What's wrong? What's wrong is this, Lily. It has to stop now. I want you to forget about this club. Dave Farber just called me a fag.
Who cares what he says?
I do. I'm not gay. Look, I want to try out for the varsity baseball team. Farber's the captain.
Okay, so the subtext here is that baseball is more important to you than civil rights?
No, please let him answer.
Why is everything so black and white with you? Why is it as somebody as smart as you can't see any side but her own? Yes, this is a noble club. Is it going to change anything at this school? No. What is it going to do? It's just going to get you hurt and me in more fights and make our life a living hell.
Amy.
No. Don't.
Josh, I'm sorry. I can't just fold this thing. Change takes time. Change starts with one person saying this is wrong and I won't tolerate it.
Look, I know you believe in what you're doing, Lily, but I need to take time away from this club. I need time to rethink this. Sorry.
Fine. As long as you realize that taking time off from the club means taking time off from me.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
No, it's exactly what you're saying, Josh. This is me. This is what I believe. I can't change that.
Lily, I admire your passion. It's one of the reasons I fell for you. But a lot of the times, I don't think you think about the repercussions of what you do and say, about your causes or about me.
You won't leave it. I want people to see what hatred looks like. I'll see you after school at the club, Harrison.
Okay.
Maybe they wrote down the wrong room number.
Thanks for supporting me, Harrison. I know this is hard.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Sugar. What's up?
Just figured I'd come check out what's going on in the PETA Club. What's shaking in the world of animal rights?
Sugar, this isn't the... it's the...
I know what club this is. I'm just a little nervous. You don't have to be gay to join, do you?
No, not at all. This club is just about providing a safe space, a forum for people to talk about fear and homophobia.
Have a seat.
I'm ashamed to say that I've been guilty of that. After the fight in the locker room and how that new kid got roasted in the cafeteria, it was like having a mirror held up to my face. And I don't want to be one of those people. I know that feeling, you know, of cruelty.
Someone say something about you?
No, people never say anything to my face. I'm usually the first to joke about my weight. It's just that recently something happened that went unspoken, and that killed me even more. You know, I got that class where you get school credit for working, so I got to get a job, right? So I go to that cool hotel on the strip, you know, where they got all those male model types hopping luggage.
Hi, I'm looking for Jared.
That's me. How can I help you?
I spoke to you on the phone about a job in a dorm in here. I open doors very well.
I'm really sorry. I filled that job already.
Really? Since I just taught you half an hour ago?
We have positions opening up in the kitchen. If you want to leave your application.
Clearly the guy was saying I was too heavy without saying it. I mean, why don't the guy just speak his mind?
This hotel is for people with style.
And you don't have any fat sweaty pig. You disgust me. Why don't you just go home and eat that pot of shit simmering in a crock pot?
But he didn't say that. So instead he said,
I'm sorry, I've filled that position already.
It's funny. I went to get a job opening doors, and because of the way I look, because I'm not homogenized like chemo glasses milk, I had one slammed right in my face. I'm sorry, guys. I didn't mean to unload all this on y'all. I didn't know who else to talk to, and this wouldn't have gone over real well with the chess club.
Maybe we should broaden our definition for discrimination support. Sometimes what's unsaid is as hurtful as words.
Yeah. I mean, if that Brian Rose kid felt have as bad as I did, even for just a minute. Or if I ever made him feel that way, I'd feel badly for him. I am him.
Okay. What about this one?
Well, it's a little Jenny Lopez Grammy Awards 2000.
You've got a point. Try it on. Please.
Okay. Miss Ferreira?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Anna Lynn, the assistant manager here at Trey Jolie Lady. All right, let's get started.
Okay, I'm being trained today. Just tell Sam to find me before you guys go.
Hi.
I don't know what's more surprising, the fact that Folding Gauchos is so involved or the fact that gauchos are back in style.
Gauchos rock. Oh, look, Carmen, see how you tuck and fold. Press with your palms. It's more presentable, and remember, in retail, presentation and uniformity is all. Here, you try it.
Okay. And hold, and press with my palms. How's that?
It's fine. You know, another thing you should know about retail, it's not just a career in style. It's a dusk till dawn battle with stress.
I bet there seems like a lot to do. You know, if you wanna go help them, I think I can handle this folding thing solo.
What's the use of helping them? They never buy. They just steal what they want.
Sorry?
Right, you can't trust those people. Watch them like a hawk.
I'm sorry, what do you mean, those people?
You know, those people.
That's racial profiling.
I call it the truth.
Hey, excuse me, we need your opinion.
Well, ladies, I am here to help.
Well, we want to know
who looks the most like Beyonce.
Come on, give it up.
Well, what do you think? Hey.
Sam, help us out here. Who looks more like Beyonce? Of Destiny's Child.
Seems somebody in my presence is an Oreo.
Mm-hmm. Black on the outside and white in the middle.
I'm sorry, what?
George, do you know these girls?
These black girls, apparently he feels he's too good for? No, he does not.
Hey, you don't know
what it's like to be black? No, you don't.
You guys, this isn't solving anything. Stop it.
Sam, change and let's go. Please.
That was really ugly and unnecessary. I'm sorry.
Speak for yourself. Did you date one of those girls or something, and that's why...
Sam, no! Get real. Those girls were just saying what a lot of people think.
But of all people, I wouldn't have expected that kind of treatment from them.
Why? You think because they're black, they should be more open-minded? Welcome to the real world, Sam.
George, just stop. Sit. Why are you angry at me?
I'm sorry. I'm not mad at you. I'm mad at a world in which many people have a problem with interracial dating.
No one's had a problem with us dating before.
Are you kidding me? Look around. Haven't you noticed the looks we've been getting?
What I choose to do is of no concern to you and your friends. It's my life.
Are you ashamed of me?
No. Sam, no.
Then why didn't you stand up to them? I mean, why didn't you let me stand up to them and tell them they were wrong? They don't know us or how we feel.
I didn't know how to deal with it. Because no matter how much I might expect it, it hurts to hear those things.
Why haven't we ever talked about this before?
I don't know. You tell me.
Honestly, I don't know. I wanted to avoid it. Just kind of...
painful. Yeah, I know.
So what are we supposed to do? Just let what other people think come between us?
I don't want that.
Good, then let's ignore him.
Like we just tried to do in the store back there? It's not that simple, Sam.
happened in the locker room.
Yeah, something like that.
I think he did the right thing. That Lily is trouble with a capital T. I mean, if she goes through with that whole club thing, then you'll have a lot more Dave Farbers to contend with.
Plus, everyone is a...
I think she's a lesbian. And if she's a lesbian, then you must be gay. At least that's what people will think. You know, scalp by association.
Yeah, so I gathered.
Believe me, I know exactly what you're going through. Like the other day at lunch, I get it all the time.
Well, what, it doesn't bother you?
Of course it does. It eats me up inside. And that is exactly why I think that we shouldn't have a club at all. Because people will get harassed even more. Some things are just better left unsaid. That's why I am.
No, why what?
If I tell you something, you promise you won't tell anyone.
Yeah. What, you huff paint?
No, man. I was the one who wrote on Lily's locker.
What? Whoa, it was you? Yo, that's seriously messed up, bro.
She had to be stopped.
Are you crazy? Do you realize that that word was one of the main reasons Lily and I broke up?
Come on, Josh. Don't you see how many problems this club is causing already?
You know, I feel sorry for you, man. Do you really hate yourself that much?
This place is so cool. I've never been here before.
A friend of mine said that this was the place to be seen now.
Really? You know, I'm on the prom committee this year.
I'll take you to the prom.
Really?
Really.
We'll see. Anyway, this place would be perfect for the prom. I mean, it would just be so sophisticated.
If you're into that.
What do you mean?
I mean, the lattes are great, Brooke, but look around.
No, they're
in the place. I don't know. I wish I'd taken you someplace else. Everybody looks alike. It's almost eerie.
God, I see what you mean. It's so weird that I didn't notice that right away.
Why is that weird?
Because I've been sort of hiding who I am to fit in. And this year, I decided that I wasn't interested in playing that game anymore.
Hey, Roth.
Is something wrong?
Now? No. Last year when I pledged the Omega House and didn't get in because that guy was the president and didn't like Jews like me. Yeah. Do you have a problem with that?
Yeah, that's horrible. He should be reported.
No, I mean with the fact that I'm Jewish. Because if you do, or if your parents are going to freak out, just tell me now. I mean, in high school, I dated this girl. She cancels the night of prom because her parents found out my religion.
Do you have a problem with the fact that I'm not Jewish?
No.
Then there's no problem. So I told Anna Lynn, the assistant manager who is apparently making a career out of making people feel less than, that I thought she was wrong. And I quit on the spot.
Sam, how are you feeling about what happened to you at the mall?
I don't know. Still a bit shocked. This week's blindness to subtleties gave way to eye-opening realizations.
One good thing did come out of it, though. At least Sam and I are now talking about an issue we never really wanted to face before. Mm.
This is a good club, Lil. I think it's really good to talk openly about this kind of stuff.
Yeah, well, bad news, guys. Krupp said if we don't find a faculty advisor by tomorrow, we're shut down.
I'm sorry, but I just have to say this. What is up with Miss Glass? I mean, you'd think out of everyone, she'd be open to the idea of a gay lesbian support group / anti-discrimination club. I mean, we don't even know if Glass is a he or a she.
Sugar, listen to what you just said.
I mean, we all say that we're against discrimination and words that hurt, but we all do it. I mean, we do it every day with Miss Glass.
We do always call her sir.
Yeah, and that's just a good-natured joke.
Yeah, but suddenly it's not so funny. You do it too, Lily.
Yeah, I do. Miss Glass?
I'm busy, and my sciatic is kicking up. In short, scram, runt girl.
I would like to put this 2-year war of words between us to rest. I want to apologize.
Oh, I get it. You think if you put the olive branch out there, you'll sweet talk me into babysitting for you and your little club? Keep dreaming.
That's not why I'm here. I want to apologize for calling you sir. We've all done it. I've done it, and you've never once reacted to it. I didn't realize until today how that word must hurt you.
It does hurt.
Well, this is for you. It's a petition that I circulated. Everyone who signed it has agreed to stop calling you sir. We decided we'll just stick with Claw. And, Ms. Glass, I know that you pride yourself on being a private person, but if you ever want to talk about anything relating to this, you have my complete confidence.
I can't talk about this with you.
You can't talk about it because you're afraid of getting fired, right? Or maybe because you're scared someone will scrawl something about you across your blackboard. Something mean and hateful, like what's on my locker. Well, anyway, keep on trucking, Miss Glass.
It's pathetic, isn't it, Esposito? That even at my age, I don't know who I am other than a teacher of chemistry. I know there's more to me. I think I've just buried things so deep. So, okay, you got me. I admit, I maybe have questions.
Well, then we need to get you some more information. So that wasn't so bad, right?
They were nice. There was also a lot of corduroy going on in there, which I enjoyed.
You'll find your answers. Everybody finds their own way on their own path in their own time.
Miss Esposito, I never thought I'd say this, but I admire your bravery. You risked something, extending your friendship to me, namely your reputation as a hipster. I know I have a reputation as a curmudgeon, a drag, a big old pain in the pants, but quite frankly, I'm damn proud of it. But because you took a risk, so will I. I would be proud to be your faculty advisor for your support group.
Really? Thank you so much. You won't regret it.
Excuse me, but could you point us to the Gay and Lesbian Community Center?
Yeah, it's right over there.
Is that where you just came from?
Uh-huh.
That's what I thought. What's the matter? You don't like what we have to give you?
Leave us alone.
Well, you dykes don't even know what you're missing.
Shut your dirty mouth.
Why don't you try and make me?
Sam, what's wrong?
I was just at the hospital.
Lily? Lily, when I find the guys who did this...
No, they already did. And it's not as bad as it looks, sweetie. I sprained my arm getting away after I got knocked down by an elbow. And I only have to stay here a day for observation. It doesn't really hurt. You should have seen Miss Glass. She was a regular crouching tiger. She put a serious hurt on two of the guys, but she couldn't take on a third, and I'm of no use, I'm afraid, because I'm so...
So little.
Yeah.
Oh, baby.
This is a big case if I told you so, huh?
No, no way, baby. I would never tell you that. You're the bravest person I know, Lily. Are you afraid?
At first, yeah. But then when I got hit, I was so just shocked. And then I just got angry. This is the first time I've really risked something for what I believe in.
Maybe you're risking a little too much here, Lily.
No, it's too dangerous not to take that risk, Josh. That's what they want, don't you see? If sticks don't work, then some of these haters, they'll start using stones, and they want to keep their world homogenized, and I don't want to live in that world. Besides, I can't quit. Now, Miss Glass agreed to sponsor the club, so I have to keep fighting, because... What's wrong?
I should have been there. And I hate myself for that. I should have been there.
Hey, guys, I was wondering if I could join your club.
Sure.
Oh, here comes trouble.
Hey, homos.
Don't you have anything better to do, like rub two sticks together and discover fire?
Haha, Brainiac. You think you'll learn something after what happened to your friend Lily?
You think it's funny what happened to her, Farba?
Yeah, I do. She had it coming.
Hey.
Fork. You know I was right about you. You can forget about baseball. Fags need not apply.
Do you need an 85-mile-an-hour fastball?
Yeah, keep dreaming, sweetheart.
Oh, it's no dream. I clocked it.
Oh, and guess what? Even though I know I could blow away any hitter in the division, I'm not going to play for your team. And I know that you'd ask me to eventually, Farber. So, when you and your scrubs are in the middle of a long, continuous losing streak and you need a good pitcher, you make sure you tell your buddies and your coach the reason why I won't play. And I'm sure he'll agree with you that promoting hate and ignorance is better than winning, right? So go tell him that, Farber, and we'll see who's on the sidelines.
You know, instead of just meeting and talking today, maybe we should do something else, like in honor of Lily.
I agree. Let's go.
Yeah.
Hi. I'm returning this dress and telling everyone I know not to shop here anymore.
And we're notifying your corporate headquarters about your racially biased retail manners.
And you might want to peruse those classifieds.
Oh, but don't worry. I'm sure that narrow-minded gaucho folders are in high demand.
Hi. Nice suit. I'm looking for Jared.
Yes, pretty lady. What can I do for you?
We have a couple of mutual friends who said that this would be a great place to have a prom.
Oh, yeah, we'd love to host.
Yeah, unfortunately, Jared, we won't hold our prom here because we don't like the way you treat some of our friends.
Yeah, we've discovered that you don't like overweight people or Jewish people, and we think that makes you... Gosh, Josh, could you help me out here? What's the word I'm looking for?
An elitist, bigoted snob?
Yes, that would be it. So we've taken the liberty of writing a letter to a Mr. Goldberg, who happens to be the corporate owner of this house of style, who, for your information, just happens to be fat and Jewish.
So we thought we would CC you in person.
I was gonna get you tiger lilies to symbolize the hell of a fight you put up, Esposito, but they're out of season. So I picked these daisies for you. Enjoy.
Beautiful. Thank you. How's your eye?
Nothing that a pound of raw sirloin turned into a nifty little compress couldn't handle. How's your arm?
On a throb scale, it's about a 6. Guess we're war buddies now, huh?
War buddies.
Thanks for sticking up for me, Miss Glass. You might have saved my life.
Yeah, kiddo, it was nothing. I needed to brush up on my redneck butt-kicking skills.
Yeah, this isn't funny.
I know. But if I don't laugh, I'll scream, you know?
Yeah. I have some great ideas for the next club meeting. I
won't be sponsoring the club, Lily.
You can't quit now. I know Krups is freaked out because of all the media attention we got, but who cares? We can meet off school grounds.
Maybe so, but not with me.
I don't understand.
Well, that's probably because you're 17 and wonderful and idealistic and not 40. You should know, this whole thing has changed me.
and I have you to thank for that. But the world hasn't changed enough to have the changed me in it, and I'm afraid. I'm afraid of all the hatred out there waiting for me. Stepping out of the homogenized mix is too risky for me. I could lose my job. I could lose the next fight. Now, I know you're probably thinking what a chicken I am, and maybe I am. And maybe tomorrow I'll wake up and find the courage to fight those battles. But not today, Lily. Not today.
It's an ugly word, isn't it?
Yes.
So I heard they shut your club down.
Yeah, they did.
People have so many fears about stuff that they don't understand, you know? Fear of anything different. Like, being gay.
Fine, it was wrong of me to ask you those personal questions the other day.
And I was wrong for writing this ugly word on your locker. I'm sorry.
Why did you do that?
I just wanted the teasing and the jokes and the feeling of being an outcast stuff to stop. I wanted to feel like I was on the right side for once, to belong, you know? I just wanted the pain to stop. And I'm guessing it's not going to.
Yeah, I'd love to argue with you, but I can't. It probably won't. There are people who will reject you because of who you are, and there are people who won't. And I guess the only way to get through it is not to face it alone, and you don't have to. Nobody does anymore. There are groups, and there's the internet.
Maybe the club can meet at my house sometime. Then we wouldn't need a sponsor, right?
What about your parents?
My parents are liberal Jews who campaigned for Clinton twice. I think they'll be down with an anti-discrimination club. No, then maybe I could tell them the rest one day.
Yeah.
I brought some stuff to clean this off with. And I know it's wrong to hate, but I hate this word. I hate it.
Tonight's episode of Popular featured music by Madonna, Dido, and Tahiti 80. Can you feel my heart there? Brooke McQueen's fallen for an older guy, but her father doesn't trust her judgment.
What do you think I'm gonna do with this guy? Because you haven't once asked me.
To follow her heart, she'll defy his authority.
That was the last time that you will ever see her.
An all-new Popular, next Friday on the WB.
Next to 10.
Now.
Straight ahead on the news at 10, a kidnapping mystery more than two decades old is solved tonight in a fascinating stolen identity case. Plus, a game of truth or dare gets out of hand at a high school in New Jersey, with kids allegedly performing sex acts and the teacher near.